Hello guys, these are 9 things I wish I knew before playing Bedward Adventure. Hope these tips and tricks will help you even if you played for a while already. Enjoy! If you want to farm scrap quickly and use up your Reaper oil fast, you can use this strategy, it's very simple. However, keep in mind you'll need to have this business upgrade for the strategy to work. The strat is the following. You put your best bots on your recruits. You yourself get whatever left bots there are. You go to the zone and summon your recruits. You let them defeat wild bots and bandits for easy scrap. While this method is somewhat good, it also has downsides. First of all, it's easy to get caught, and once you have to fight enemies, you can easily lose with bad bots. So you end up wasting your Reaper oil. To not get caught requires some patience. Otherwise, this strat is perfect for quickly using up your oil if you have not much time to play. Always make sure you choose gold missions for your recruits. For higher chances of success, use the best recruit you have for these kind of missions. Generally, gold is the best thing you can get from this. Usually though, especially later in the game, you can get some good rare rewards as well, like bot pack abilities or rare scrap. Since you will have 2 or even 3 recruits at this point, you should be able to always get the best deals. The best starter is Ram. If you chose him, congrats. If you didn't, don't worry. You should get him somewhat early in the game. Make sure to keep some resources for his upgrades because it's a top tier bot. And again, don't worry if you didn't go for him. I myself took Froggy and it was fine too. All starters are decent. This is a strategy that can make you a little weaker in the early game, but then give you a big boost later. So, as you progress in the game, you start unlocking new, better drops and loot. For example, before you are average level 10, you cannot drop rare bot resources that are required to upgrade bots past level 10. It's similar with bot essences that are required to upgrade bots past level 20. The idea is that generally you get worse drop earlier and much better around level 10 and then around level 19 or 20. With that in mind, you could keep your chests from progressing the starter season and perhaps from arena, because these are the only chests you can keep for longer. Once you feel like you have a high enough level and you get a lot better rewards, then you can open the chest and possibly have much better loot. A big disclaimer here. I don't know if this works. Perhaps the chests you get have rewards inside of them the moment you get them, to avoid this kind of mechanic abuse. So keep that in mind, it's not sure it works, but you can try it out and let me know. Let's look at some examples of good bot combos. As always, I advise my Flamer strat, which is very easy early game because it requires common bots. Fun fact, you can do that strat with basically any area damage bot. It can be Mort instead of Flamer, it can be even Brute. Anything that deals damage in area will do well. The key is scatter stun here. The same can be done in bandit fights and arena, but this time we can't use scatter, and instead we use Chainer. Chainer is a bot specifically designed for this kind of stuff. However, he doesn't stun and he is countered by lots of obstacles on the ground, so keep that in mind. A very helpful tool to set up combos is Ghast ability. I have it at all times. Have in mind you need specific boosters for these combos, especially the ones that shorten the cooldown of ultimate abilities of bots or charge them at the beginning of battle. Make sure to also choose the AI that does that as well. Prioritize the generators in both business upgrades. Later, make sure you get the one that allows your recruits to collect scrap. Also, The one increasing effectiveness of your Reaper canister is great. If you want to use the strategy of farming with recruits, get the Recruit Reaper one as well. The rest is up to you. In squad cups, you win by winning 2 matches out of 3 or later 3 out of 4. So, you can put your best bots on your recruits and get bad bots yourself. So, even though you lose your own fight, you win overall. Keep in mind that the enemies can also do that, so you won't always win with this strategy. Still, it's somewhat good to know and it's very useful. In general, I think I win more using that strat. In the arena, you can check enemy abilities and boosters by tapping here. It may not be very helpful early in the game, but later it definitely allows you to better prepare your strategy for the fight. Seeing enemy abilities is especially useful. Hopefully you're gonna win more by knowing that. Here are the best unit types in the game and what counters what. Keep in mind, this is my personal assessment. So, to explain this. Generally, the best bot types are Sniper, Splasher and Brawler. Simply because they do the most damage out of all types and you need damage to win. So, naturally, they are the most crucial in your setup. Moreover, they counter almost all bots if they are placed and used correctly. So, if Brawler fights in melee, if Sniper is safe away from enemies, and if Splasher has proper combo setup for him with either bot pack abilities like Gust or Vortex, or bots like Chainer or Scrappy. Then there are Chasers. They have huge 1v1 damage, but still will lose to Brawlers and Tanks. And naturally, they will be defeated by anything ranged if the ranged bots get the chance to freely attack them. Still, they are almost S tier for me, because how useful they are when dealing with ranged bots in melee range. They are also good to keep evaders busy. Another bots right after are Tanks. They are great, but usually you need only one to keep enemies busy and soak up big damage for your other bots. So, while they are very crucial to your win, they don't do the main job and are somewhat easily countered by Brawlers and Splashers that attack multiple targets. Finally, we have evaders. I personally don't see them as very strong. Yes, they are irritating, but they don't seem to deal enough damage to make a difference in fights. Especially in PvP arena, your focus is to defeat the enemy bots as fast as possible, before they defeat you. What's more, you usually fight stronger opponents in arena. That's why you want to end the fight quickly, because the longer the fight is, the difference in levels and quality of bot pack abilities will matter more. You don't want to stall the fight versus a stronger opponent. So far, the only strategy that could use evaders well would be going all in for damaging bot pack abilities. At least it's what I think. So, you run from enemies and defeat the bots with Zap Tower, Unstable Plasma and other damaging bot pack abilities. Well, I think that's all I have to say about this graph. Keep in mind that it's all a subject to change in the future. At the moment of making this video, the game still hasn't released and is in early access. So, yeah, it can all change, but I think it's still somewhat useful for the beginners and as a general advice. So, that was it, guys. Consider subscribing and see you in next videos.